She's a married woman.
I know.
Even Papa does not seduce other men's wives.
No, but I don't think Papa has ever fallen in love either.
I think that my brother will have a very happy marriage.
Yes.
You should go home. And I must face this alone.
Yeah. But you are not alone, are you?
I do not think that I would be so lucky.
And is your other half so very bad?
What do you think, Duchess?
I think, sir, you are a sheep in wolf's clothing. You pretend to be what my mother would call a rake, but underneath, I think you have a heart that is tender.
That you flatter me, Duchess.
No, sir. I just describe what I see. A truly happy marriage is a rare, in my experience.
I wanted to tell you that I will be going back to Coburg shortly. Albert thinks that I would be safer there.
Safer? I hardly think you're in much danger from a harmless flirtation with a married woman.
You think that this is harmless?
Don't you?
No.
I hope you have enjoyed your stay, sir.
I will never forget it.
If you had married a different kind of man, one who thought about you every moment you were alive, one who saw the way the curls fell on your neck in his dreams, then I think your experience would be different.
I believe this is yours, Duchess.
Indeed it is. I must have dropped it somewhere.
Did you miss me?
I suppose there were moments when I pondered the whereabouts of my handkerchief.
My whole life.
It's madness, but I couldn't find the words to my feelings.
The favor I asked for in my note. Will you give it to me?
Yes, I went to Harriet's room. And if I were the man that you think I am, I could have taken everything. But I chose not to, out of my love for her. I want her so much.
I wish I could make you happy.
But all I took in her room was this. A lock of her hair. Nothing more. We have this moment.